Exodus thinks he met you looking a certain way. You were his queen. And then, 2 years down the road, you're eating like there's no tomorrow. You're all growing fat. He likes his woman slim. And that's why he, you know, he went for you in the first time. Isaac thinks it's a two-way traffic. Yeah? If she thinks she's losing the spark, call her. Mukwane continuously. Okukwana kwetaga. You need to continue kwanaring her every day. Yeah? And as mothers, we know that when a baby comes, things change. Yes? So how do you expect you are the one who got me pregnant? In the first, Exodus, you think a woman is going to stay the same way after having babies?
I've seen examples of women that have had multiple children and they still look like they looked when you met them. So I'm judging from that point of view.
Every woman is different. Everyone, we are all different. We have different bodies, don't we?
We do. We have different bodies. And it depends, actually. If you give birth and you maintain yourself all the time, that's also different. But your man has to help you. Mm-hmm. Like, he has to make you. Yeah, he has to keep you telling you look beautiful. Honey, let's go to the gym. Let's do some sit-ups. But most men, like you've said, the lady will continue eating, giving, but he wants kids all the time.
Of course. He's like, you've given me 4 boys. Mm-hmm. I want 2 girls.
2 more, 3 more. Honey, I want to be the same.
But we all know, we all know, looking good and keeping shape is a workout, you understand? So why do you, there are things that are common sense, you understand? You love your woman, listen, what I'm saying is, you love your woman, definitely you have to remind her every single day. Like I say, the reverse is also true.
Men forget. They forget to pamper you.
That is not true.
They do forget. Exodus, women are different.
Let me tell you.
Let me give you an example.
Mary, by the time somebody forgets,
let me give you an example.
By the time you think somebody's forgetting, there's something wrong. Something is not working.
Let me give you an example. Yeah. I had my first baby in 2016. I had my second baby in 2018. Yes? This year, I had my second baby. So, meaning I conceived my second when my first was a year. Look at me.
That's what I'm saying. Look at you.
But I have not spent even 5 seconds in the gym. I've never gone to the gym.
Okay.
Yes. I wouldn't even have the time to work out because I'm a working mother of 2. I don't have the time to go to the gym. Mm-hmm.
So,
yes.
What
well, my secret is very simple. I breastfeed. And that's how I lose my baby weight.
But like you said, women are different. So there's a woman that's
You don't know where I'm going with this one. You are not going to help me babysit. Mm-hmm. I'm a working mother. You're not going to help me. You're not going to help me breastfeed. Because breastfeeding also needs a partner's. Believe it or not, you need to help me adapt to the breastfeeding.
Madam, when you see your support is not
like that. You're getting it all wrong. Lactation is work. It's a lot of work. Yes, sometimes a woman is not going to breastfeed because she put the baby on the boob and the baby just did not latch. And as a father, you're supposed to continuously, there's a boo-boo, grab the nipple, kill, you know, you.
Yeah, like you I need, say, you need, like
and
I
then,
say.
And no, and then, if I want to create time for me to go out and do, you're not going to help in babysitting.
Why not?
No, men don't do that. They want to hang out with the boys.
Just, they want to go catch up on a drink. Say, some men don't do that. Don't say men don't do that. I know men.
Most of
I
the men have weekend plots.
Yeah.
They want to go watch football.
Actually, when the baby cries at night, honey, the baby, those things, you see. And most times men, when you give birth, you actually see as something different. That's why most guys now, most relationships, the lady gets pregnant, gives birth, and that's it. The guy doesn't see him the same way.
Chovola, but you have your seeds planted everywhere. Because you can't. Nze simuzala mune mudako. Techisoboka.
I have my seeds in one place and I thank God.
You should thank God.
All
in fact,
them.
By Sajaba no Bagambi.
I thank
Tuko
God.
Tukoye for Katina you to plant ye, your stuff everywhere.
Today, wali bottom line. Mary, like you said, women are different, yeah? men are different. So don't say men don't. Say some men. Don't generalize.
We have to generalize you.
No. I know men who will take their children's time very special. Like, that doesn't matter. Right now is my baby time. You understand?
Are you that kind
bonding
of man?
Bonding and nurturing.
One, I think we're confusing so many things. One, when you talk about breastfeeding, it doesn't mean that you have to have the kid on your breast all the time.
Mm-hmm.
That is exclusive breastfeeding. There's inclusive breastfeeding where you can actually go to the supermarket, get a powder, make the milk and give to the child.
But exclusively for 6 months.
Exactly.
And it has its benefits. I have never treated an infection.
Yes. But what we're driving at is when you say he should help you breastfeed. Sometimes women get tired and you have to...
Listen,
I understand this. Women have it's to do true. So many chores in the house. But as a man, you can say, since you're breastfeeding, let me help you cook. Let me help you do the laundry.
The support we're talking about. Like yes. That.
Yes.
I don't like... You see, like me in particular, I love cooking. I'm a chef. I'm a very good chef, by the way. You understand?
You want to cook for me?
You have your own man. Anyway, what I'm saying is...
What does that have to do with anything?
Your man has to cook for you. If he doesn't, I am sorry. But he has to.
He does, Bambi. He does.
Yeah. Helping, like I said, some things are just common sense. You understand? Omuchara afunye omwana. Mufunye omwana. You understand?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. There are certain things you definitely have to excuse her from for a certain period of time if you can. Because there are men that are extremely busy trying to work so hard, sometimes 18 hours for the family. And the only time they have is when they get back home extremely tired.
But do you know that the women who, most of the women who lose baby weight is because they've been supported by their partners? Every time I see guys by the roadside jogging with their women, you can see she's a new mother, but he's supporting her in the evening mu traffic jam agam itawano because he wants to keep the sexy in the bedroom.
Exactly. But auntie Chen Kugamba, you understand, you will blame the men entirely, but it is not entirely the man to blame entirely, because oinzo gama mchala wo baby tugende tudukeko ochitegera nga nzenko ye nziruka nzirukirachi. You at the house, no matter, baby, you know what, yeah? Sit-ups can help us with abs. Can we do some? You understand? I'm not saying entirely as well. You understand? But what I'm saying is, bottom line, yeah? We have to, individually, because when nakusangira sinze nakutunuzo bulunji nenkukwana, wali udabika bulunji nenkukwana. You understand? So, fembi individual, we have to love what we had. We have to keep that first love for self. Mary, I anticipate myself when I'm 45 still looking like this. Why? Because I love myself. You understand?
So you think the women who let go...
I think they don't love themselves.
Mary, I think there's one thing we didn't answer back there. We talked about guys who vibe you. After it's done, they run away. Yeah. Now, I'd like to educate some women out there that you can actually tell characteristics of such guys.
Hit and run.
He's always checking on your status updates. Two, whenever you post something, he's commenting. Three, he's always calling you at night.
Why
is he calling you at night all the time? Why not at daytime? Why? One, because he wants to see you. Two, because he wants to ask, okay, are you free right now? Three, because I have OTT at that time. I can, these are some of the things that actually.
But then that also brings me to another. Why are women? Why are we so free? Women, why are we always so available? You can't say no. You can't see me now. Huh? Why are we always so available?
And that's why I'm saying.
No wonder they hit us and run.
Exactly. That's why I'm saying. Sometimes as a woman, you need to make a choice of, okay, is this the kind of man I'm looking out for? Of why does he have to communicate to me at weird hours of the night? Because that's how you tell.
No, that, Isaac.
That's how I hit and run.
No, but let me tell you something. Every guy in the beginning is the sweetest guy ever. You can't tell me that he'll call you at the right time. He'll call you in the morning, honey, did you sleep well in the night? But after you get pregnant and get the baby out, it's when he goes. That's when
that's why I'm saying you
can't. No, but you can't know.
But then also the men who call you or that they also don't have jobs.
They have jobs. Okay, no, he can wake up in the morning. You know, a good darling guy would say, I woke up, I'm at work, are you fine? Then at lunchtime, I'm going for lunch. He's being good. But after that, he gets into your pants, then that's it. It's not, he will not show the true characters that you'll call you at night, OTT.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying.
But you can't know.
Characteristics never hide.
Exactly.
Characteristics never hide. You can filter.
You can filter out such kinds of people.
I think sometimes they do.
They do.
Do you think we are stupid? Do you think we are stupid that we never see it coming? Why does it repeatedly happen? Don't give me that face. You're about to say, what?
Let me ask Exodus. If you're saying characteristics hide, sorry to ask
don't
about...
Don't hide.
They don't hide.
Yeah.
Let me ask you something. When you marry someone, why do things fail? Did they hide? Didn't you see that before? You're even talking about OTT at night. Didn't it show? People are getting married and people are divorced, but they never see those things coming.
Most times, you've seen these things, but because of the emotional attachment to this person, you tend to ignore certain things. Winzo kubaka mububiri, by the way. You concur with me. Kainzo kubaka mububiri.
Ngakachi. Ngakachi yako, akainzo kuziba maso.
Akainzo kuziba maso. Say,
I'll call you back.
Omukazi muyombi. You understand? I'm giving an example. Say, omukazi muyombi.
Ngakukaita ka.
Ruakuba. You've fallen for this person. You're getting things going so fast. So you ignore certain things and you see.
And then they come back to bite you in the behind.
It's possible.
So you think that's what
it's
happens?
Very possible.
Is that what happens?
It's possible.
I don't think so.
It's possible.
Sometimes it goes wrong. Okay, like you've said, you can be in a relationship with someone and it's going right, and you're all at par. You're like, there's a time my auntie asked me, if you're going to be with this man, what is that one behavior that you can live with forever? Mm-hmm. That's why you go in a relationship with someone. Mm-hmm. That's why you get married with them, you see? But then after 10 years, you're like, you have 3 kids and you're like, I can't live with this person. Why? Why can't you make it happen? You saw that one behavior.
For example.
No gama njaka gumira. Kati wacho ugana. No gama.
Watch to kagumira kati. 10 years later.
10 years.
Ayonge deko sauti. Nzi kati ayombe sa... wabage no kuyomba alete chalocho nana chukunganya nagama katikati sawazimu ngenda move on.
Auntie Mary, bottom line zen kugambia, there are those little things you will ignore because you are emotionally invested at the moment.
Mm-hmm. So that means that you emotionally withdraw after 10 years.
That's not what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. I'm talking about little things that are ignored.
A little thing we are ignoring now can become a big deal later. If it's little now, why don't you keep it little?
Mary, have you heard of, oh my God, I saw this, but I did not take it seriously. For real.
Anyway, is there a little thing that you're going to see in your man? One of that habits or the kind of person he is? It's annoying, it's ugly, but because you're like Exodus says, emotionally invested in the beginning, you ignore it and then it comes back to bite you. If you see something you don't like as a woman, withdraw completely. But if you think you're going to live with it now, baby, please be sure to live with it 10, 20 years later. Share your experience with us on our Facebook pages. I really, really, really need to hear from you because it is very confusing. Use the hashtag Salon Talk and we'll be right back. Do not even think about going anywhere.